Welcome. In this video, we're going to give an overview of the REST API available within Zephyr for Jira. The REST API is available natively as a part of Zephyr, so no further installation of any components are needed. Let's begin this overview by discussing two components that may seem similar within Zephyr for Jira: the test automation integration, which is covered in a separate video, versus the REST API, and when to use each. So when looking at the test automation integration and the native REST API, it's important to remember the use cases for each functionality. The test automation integration is really meant for when you need to upload test results from a supported framework that we offer in product. This includes Cucumber, Selenium, SOAP UI, UFT, Tricentis Tosca, Eggplant, and any framework using either a TestNG or a JUnit report. This functionality is directly in product and very easy to use. You can either directly upload results from a results file, or using a remote agent, upload from any machine into the Zephyr. And like I said, easy to use without any API experience. The REST API is useful if you want to integrate with any business intelligence tools, any test automation frameworks not supported by our direct product integration, or any CI/CD tool available. You can then take this data and also feed it into extensive custom reports outside of Jira if there's any other platforms you're using for your data. And overall, any use of the testing data, any purpose that you may have generally, you can use this REST API to pull directly from Zephyr. This does require knowledge of REST APIs, so you do have to be a bit technical. To access our REST API, you do need to be familiar with the JWT authentication required. You have to generate a JWT token to use in other REST API calls, and it follows the standard format for this token. It's required in the header for further API calls in Zephyr. The prerequisite components include the Zephyr access and seeker key, the account ID, and you can find it in a specific URL listed here, and the Zephyr base URL, which for Jira Cloud remains the same for everyone. Let's go into Jira and actually find out how to find these different pieces so that we can authenticate into our REST API. To get the Zephyr access and secret key, go to your Jira instance and under Apps, select Zephyr. Looking at the Zephyr menu, under Integrations, you'll see API keys. And this is where you'll find both the access key and secret key that you will use to generate your JWT token. The next component you need is your account ID, which is found at this URL using your Jira instance name. Once you navigate to this page, you'll see a JSON response with the second element being the account ID, which you will use for your JWT authentication and your API calls. You can save this information since it doesn't change and is tied to your account. Once you have all of our components, you can download the Java authentication client from our documentation to input them and generate the JWT token. Just look for the base URL, access key, secret key, and account ID fields and replace it with the relevant information. Once you've done this, you can execute the Java command and get the JWT token to use in your REST API. Now that you've successfully authenticated into the REST API, you can now use the access key and JWT token to make API calls into your Zephyr instance. Like this example, where I'm getting information about our servers using our REST API. You now have access to over 30 Zephyr API endpoints that can be used to create, read, update, or delete information from Zephyr. Some examples include getting a traceability report, updating your test cycle, and creating your test execution. You can explore all there is to offer within the API documentation to integrate with the other work you're doing around your testing processes. Thank you for watching. Please refer to our documentation for more information on using the REST API within Zephyr for Jira.